Hello students, I am Isha Maitiratta. In today's video, I will be discussing the topic types of fiber optic cables. So let's first start with the classification of fiber optic cables and let's see on what factors these cables are classified. So there are three factors on which the fiber optic cables are classified. The first one is on the basis of materials used. Secondly, we have on the basis of modes, number of modes which are transmitted through the cable. And the third one is on the basis of refractive index profile. One by one, I'll explain all of them. So coming on to the first one, that is on the type of materials used, we have two types of fibers. The first one is known as a glass fiber and the second one is known as a plastic fiber. Next, if I want to discuss on the basis of number of modes transmitted, we again have two categories. One is known as a single mode fiber and the second one is known as a multi-mode fiber. Coming on to the refractive index profiles, we have number one, a step index fiber, and number two, a graded index fiber. So we will be studying all these categories one by one. So coming on to the first topic, starting with the classification based on the materials used, we have the first one, which is known as plastic core with plastic cladding. The core material is also made of plastic and the cladding is also made of plastic. We all know the five layers of fiber optic cable. Innermost is core, then we have cladding and then the three protective layers. So this is a type of fiber which has a core and cladding both made up of plastic material. Let's see, they have core and cladding both made up of plastic. So this makes the production of such type of a fiber easier because both the materials are plastics. This is a flexible fiber. It is easy to install. It is less in weight, very low weight. It is less expensive and it can withstand a good amount of stress. And it gives more attenuation. What do you mean by the word attenuation? Attenuation means you can say signal loss. If your signal while traveling through the cable is absorbed more, the output would be very less, right? So if there is a higher absorption, and plastic cables always have a higher attenuation, that is the reason they can be used for short distance communication only. Let's have a look at plastic fibers. This is how the plastic fibers look like. You might have seen sometimes they are used in night lamps, the shade lamps also. All the fibers coming out from the lamp, this is nothing but a plastic fiber. Examples of plastic fiber, it can be a polystyrene core made up of polystyrene and the cladding made up of methyl methacrylate. Or there is a second option available which has a polymethyl methacrylate core and cladding made up of its copolymer. So these are the two combinations which are very commonly used in case of a plastic fiber. So this was the first category. Now let's see the second type of fiber which is known as the glass core with a plastic cladding. Core of glass and cladding of plastic. They are commonly known as the PCS fiber. It is known as plastic clad silica. Silica is nothing but glass. So glass which is having a plastic cladding is known as a PCS fiber. They have comparatively low attenuation. Why? Because the core is of glass. So it will have comparatively less absorption. So more signal can be transmitted along. So they possess a low attenuation characteristic and they are affected by radiation slightly. They are used in military purposes. Defense services commonly use this type of fiber. This is how the fiber is represented. You can see the innermost layer is of glass, that is silica, and then you have a plastic core. So this is a second type of fiber which is known as glass core plastic cladding or the PCS fiber. Now I'll start with the third one, which is known as the glass core with glass cladding, or known as the commonly known as the SCS fiber. SCS means silica clad silica. Cladding is also of glass and core is also of glass. Such fibers are best for propagation. They have the best characteristic. They have the least attenuation. Plastics have the largest attenuation. comparatively less PCS and the least is of SCS fiber. So attenuation, as I said, is better, the least absorption, so lowest attenuation. This is how a glass fiber looks like. So core is also of glass and cladding is also of glass. And examples are, you have silicon dioxide, SiO2 core with P2O5 and SiO2, a combination of phosphorus pentoxide and silicon dioxide as cladding, or the other hand, just swap it. P2O5 SiO2 core or SiO2 cladding. So this is the third type of fiber. Now, you must be wondering that we have two possibilities, core and cladding, and we have two types of materials, glass and plastic. So there should be four options. First, we have already discussed plastic core, plastic cladding. Second, we have discussed glass core, plastic cladding. And third, we have discussed glass core, glass cladding. Do you think the fourth one is possible? That means I have a plastic core and a cladding of glass. No, that is not possible. Why? Because plastic has a lower refractive index than glass. So if your core is made up of plastic and cladding is made up of glass, you will not get TIR. So the fourth combination of fiber, that is plastic core and glass cladding, is not possible. So these were the fibers based on the materials used. Now let us discuss the second category, which is on the basis of modes of propagation. In this type, in this category, I have the first one, which is known as a single mode. Single mode, the name itself says that the light will travel as a single path. Inside one cable, we have a single path of light to carry the signals. So if there is only one path for light to propagate down the cable, the fiber is known as a single mode fiber. The diagram will give you a better clarity, which I'll be explaining you shortly. Now, in such fibers, the core diameter is very, very small. The range is 7 to 10 micrometers. The diameter of the core is extremely small. Such cables are used for long haul communications, thousands of kilometers communication. Let's see what is a single mode fiber. So this is the front view. If I just cut the fiber, the front view, in which you can see a white colored circle, a small dot, which has a diameter range of 8 to 10 micrometers. Then the dark blue colored represents around 125 micrometer diameter, that is the core. And then due to the protective layers, the light blue has a maximum range of 250. So the three layers, protective layers, are not shown. We have only shown the core and cladding, that is clearly seen in the diagram. This is the front view of the fiber. Now let's see how single mode propagates. So in the diagram, you can see the blue color is the core, then you have the cladding. And in between, a yellow colored light is traveling as a straight line, straight horizontal line, you can see in the diagram. Now I'll explain you using a short animation. You can see in between the core that there is only one dot which is quickly moving continuously. Below it, it is written 9 by 125. What do you mean by this? 9 micrometers is the diameter of core and 125 micrometers is the diameter of cladding. So 9 by 125 actually represents the diameter of core and cladding. This is how a single mode fiber propagates. The signal propagates through this type of fiber. Now let's see the second type of cable on the basis of number of modes, which is known as a multi-mode fiber. The name itself says multi means more than one. So if the light takes more than one path to propagate down the cable, such a type of fiber is known as a multi-mode fiber. Let's see what a multi-mode fiber is. So it has a diameter which is approximately in the range of 20 to 100 micrometers. So comparing with a single mode fiber, it has almost 10 times more diameter of core. That gives more space to light and that leads to more number of modes to travel along the cable. This is ideal for high bandwidth and medium haul communications. Why medium haul communications? Because in such fibers, if the light after entering the cable takes different paths, overall the signal which will be received at the output end will not be at the same time. I can say my signal will come in pieces. One portion, second portion, third portion. So that if it is used for very, very long communications, very, very long distance communications, it won't give me accurate results. Let's have a look at the multimode fiber. So this diagram, you can see the innermost core has a range of around 62.5 micrometer is the diameter. I just now mentioned it has a range of core diameter 20 to 100 micrometer. Then the dark blue colored shows 125 micrometer is the diameter of cladding and then the overall diameter of the fiber. Let's have a look at the multimode. So blue color represents the core. You can see there are many yellow parts inside the cable. So each and every portion will carry some portion of the data, some portion of the information. So at the receiving end, all the information won't come together. It will come in pieces, pulses. Clear? Let's have a look at the animation, which can show you that the light is splitting up into different paths. So at the output end, you can see that you are not getting a continuous signal. 50 by 120, so 50 micrometers is the diameter of core and 125 is the diameter of cladding. So this is how a multimode fiber gives us propagation in different paths. Now, let us move on to the third category, which is known as classification on the basis of index profile. Before we move on to the third category, which is based on index profile, let's have a look what index profile is. So index profile is nothing but a curve or a graph which is representing variation of refractive index. How refractive index varies along the vertical axis with respect to horizontal distance along the horizontal axis. So refractive index is along the vertical axis, distance is along the horizontal axis from the axis of fiber. So this will be clear once we move on to the categories and then I'll show you the graph. So the first type of fiber based on index profile is known as the step index fiber. This is a fiber which has a central core, which has a core. Throughout the core, the uniform refractive index is there. You have the same refractive index throughout the core. So just move from one end of core to the other end throughout this distance. Refractive index remains the same. Let's have a look at the graph. So this is the graph. You can see that the light blue color represents the core. Then you have cladding and then finally the yellow portion is the buffer jacket. We are not concerned about the buffer jacket at this point. You can see the graph below. Vertical axis means refractive index variation. Horizontal axis means distance, the horizontal distance. You can see that you get a step-like graph. What does this step indicate? This step indicates that refractive index is same. It is refractive index is on the vertical axis. If it is the same point, you will get a straight line. If it is not same, you won't get a straight line. So here you are completely getting a step-like shape. That is the reason it is known as a step index fiber. This is how the step index fiber can propagate. Single mode and multimode. So there are both the options. We'll be discussing it later. Next comes the second type of fiber on the basis of index profile, which is known as the graded index fiber. This fiber has a non-uniform core with highest refractive index at the center. And when you move away from the center, the refractive index decreases gradually. So instead of a straight line, it is maximum at the center and slowly, slowly the refractive index decreases. So instead of a step, you will be getting this shape. Let's have a look at the diagram. You can see in the diagram below that maximum at the center and it gradually decreases towards the cladding. This is the meaning of graded index fiber and let's see how light propagates through a graded index fiber. So this is how it propagates. So instead of traveling straight, it will bend, 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 bend and like this, the light will flow. Light will propagate. And on the other hand, you can see the variation. The variation is like a curve shape instead of a straight line. This is the meaning of graded index fiber. Today, we have discussed the varieties of fibers based on materials, based on number of modes, and based on index profile. So we have discussed all possibilities of fibers. Hope you have understood all the topics I explained today very well. Thank you.